So hello, welcome to St James's Park. The queue still here for fans to get on the buses to the Stadium of Light. It is Derby Day, of course, Sunderland versus Newcastle on Wearside. FA Cup third round, the first derby since 2016. Been outside with the fans for a couple of hours now. It's just started to rain as well, but the spirits are high. Here's what they had to say.
It's the world. I would say 5-0. Isaac first, and I think Gordon might get that trick.
After all this time, 2016, what does it feel to finally have a Derby back?
Oh, it's brilliant. It's the best thing you can do. Best things for us, the best thing for them, because they'll get beat again.
It's my second one, it's my first one away, so I'm excited.
What's the score
going to
be?
6-1.
To them.
And ask you what the
Derby
means to yourself?
As long as we'll win. That's what the big meaning of it is. It's a massive, massive game for us. And as long as we'll win, you know, and I hope we'll win comfortably. Yeah.
We will.
I think we will. Yeah, definitely.
What does the Derby mean to you?
Getting back to the old days when it used to be great fun.
What does the Derby mean to you, sir?
It means everything.
What's the score going to be?
3-0. Isaac 2 and Bruno.
Thank you. Derby means to them. So what does Derby mean to yourself?
Oh, everything. Just got to beat them. No, they've got chips on their shoulders, so give me a few more chips.
Have it back after so long, 2016. What does it feel to finally have a Derby back?
I don't like Derbies.
And Newcastle going to win though.
Absolutely.
What does it mean to me? More than anything, it's the biggest match of the season, hands down, that you're ever going to get. It's like a cup final, Champions League final, World Cup final, all rolled into one. Of course you are, absolutely. You can't even think about a loss.
What's the score going to be?
It's going to be 3-0.
Can I ask you what it means to you?
Everything.
Everything. I've just seen the Derek here, I mean Michael. I've just missed one since the late 60s. And that's I couldn't get a ticket for the Nobby Solano penalty game. So I've been to every single one since, home and away. Difficult one. My head says one thing and my heart says another. My head says, just put them to the sword. My heart says, well, it's a good day out. Newcastle will definitely win if they play as they can. If they perform as professionally as they can, then Sunderland won't be able to live with the standard of football we play. I think Sunderland will just, they'll have their moments. They'll play pretty patterned football, but they're too lightweight, too inexperienced. And I think we'll just out-muscle them, outplay them, and comfortably win the game.
It's like Christmas. I haven't had a particularly brilliant Christmas, but it feels like Christmas morning for me. I'm bouncing. I haven't been asleep. My eyes, I'm just all over the place. My mind's thinking of just 100 things at the minute. Get me there, get me in the atmosphere. There's DJs going on. Everyone's got black and white scarves on the corner and the singing. It's what we want. It's your DNA. It's your Newcastle United. You're a Geordie, and I'm sure it's echoed on the other side with the Sunderland as well. I'm sure they're feeling exactly the same. I'm really, really excited. I'm just get me there, get me there.
It's everything. It's absolutely everything. Like, you can play Liverpool, you can play Man United, you can play Man City, but to beat Sunderland at Sunderland in the FA Cup. Could you imagine if we won the FA Cup and you beat Sunderland on the way? Like, there's just no response. And the fact that they've decorated the Black Cats Bar, whatever it's called, in black and white as well, it's just really nice of them, but what would be nicer would just be a win today, because that's what we need.
flags are in town.